Would you like to learn to make a design that can be easily adjusted without redoing the whole project from scratch? Today we are going to use Fusion 360 to design this simple storage box using user parameters, so we can easily adjust everything we need after the design is complete. In this video we will learn what you need to know before setting the user parameters, how to set user parameters correctly, and what you need to pay attention to when designing. Hi, I'm Davis from Aribabox, and I have made over 150 designs using user parameters. If you would like to see what can be made on your CNC router, make sure you click that subscribe button. First things first, we have to understand how the user parameters work. And to be honest, it's really simple. All we have to do is set parameter we might need to adjust later, use previously set parameters when specifying distances, angles, or other features, and adjust the parameter if necessary in the spreadsheet. And that's basically it. So let's open up the user parameters. The tool is located under the modify section. I personally have pinned the user parameters to the toolbar since I use it frequently, and that way I can access it faster whenever I need it. Anyway, here we can see an empty spreadsheet. And before we set any parameters, I would recommend considering what dimensions you might have to change later, after the sketching or modeling is done. And the reason for this is simple. We don't want to forget any important dimensions, and certainly we don't want to overdo it as well, since unnecessary parameters might complicate the modeling. So for this box, we could set the height as the first parameter. We can do it by clicking the plus symbol next to the user parameters. We can name the parameter and select the units for it in the drop-down menu. There are a couple of most common units available, and also, if you scroll down, there are some more advanced ones as well. In the expression window, we can specify a value we have in mind for the parameter. And of course, here we can add a comment. This is a useful thing when you are collaborating on your project with someone. After clicking OK, the newly set parameter will appear in the spreadsheet. Alright, I will quickly set parameters for the width, length, plywood thickness, and router bit diameter. Oh, by the way, in this window you can write simple expressions using previously set user parameters, and the value will adapt if we change one of the other parameters we have used in this expression. When parameters are set, we can start sketching. However, before we start, there are some things that we have to know when sketching in Fusion 360. Most importantly, we have to understand the types of lines available. The first type of line is the contour line, which we are going to use later when constructing the outline for our components. The second type of line is the construction line. I like to think of it as a skeleton to whom everything else is attached. Then there is the center line, which basically serves as the symmetry axis when using the mirror function. Alright, let's get started by creating a new component. You just have to right-click on the project in the browser and select Create New Component. I recommend making each part as a separate component. That way it's easier to organize your work, and it also simplifies editing some features while you are designing. When the component is ready, we can start sketching. Click Create Sketch in the toolbar and select one of the given faces. I usually select X and Y face, since that way the finished components are already correctly positioned for CNC operations. Okay, let's start building the construction base. I usually start by drawing a rectangle using the construction lines. Then we can set the first dimensions. You can find the dimensions command in the Create section. If it's not pinned to your toolbar, you can just click on the drop-down menu here, find the dimensions command and left-click on the three dots here. Then after checking the pinned to the toolbar box, it will appear to your toolbar. You can do the same for other commands you use most often. Alright, let's define the length of this line. Right-click on the line, drag out the dimension, and right-click again. In this field we can type any dimension we like, for example 100 mm. Click Enter. When we double-click the dimension, we can modify it. So let's write height to use our first parameter. As you can see, it shows FX next to the dimension. That means it has synchronized with the parameter we have set before. Okay, let's click D for dimensions on your keyboard and specify this distance as length. Now we have the frame for the first side. We can add a construction line that will help to illustrate where the corner joint will be located. We can write plywood here, so it will automatically adjust to your material thickness whenever you make a change in the user parameter spreadsheet. Let's draw two lines at the bottom section to illustrate where the box floor will go. We can add a dimension that specifies the distance between these lines, and again write plywood here. There obviously has to be some material left at the bottom, so the box floor doesn't stay on your table when you lift the box up. So I will add 13 millimeters here. Alright, let's add the center line in the middle of the rectangle. The triangle here means that the center line endpoint is also a midpoint for this line. Now we have finished the construction of the component and it's time to add the outline. It's the easiest part, however, there are a couple of things you have to pay attention to in order for the parametric design to work. It's important that the endpoints of the outlines are attached to the sketch lines. If they are not coincident, they won't adjust when some user parameters are changed. To fix that, all you have to do is select coincident command from the constraint section. Select the endpoint and right-click on the construction line. Now it will work. It's important to set dimensions for the outlines as well, especially for the joints. By the way, when specifying a dimension, you can write expressions, so you don't have to keep the calculator open in the background. So far we have designed one half of the side. I will quickly make some adjustments to the corners that will make the boxes stackable. Alright, now we have to open the mirror command and select all the outlines we just sketched. Click OK. And now we have done the sketch for this side. After selecting finish, we can extrude the contour in a 3D model. You can find the extrude command here or click E for extrude on your keyboard. We will select all the sections we want to be extruded. And here in the distance window we can type plywood. So the component will adjust automatically when you change the material thickness in the user parameters. The first component is done. We can copy the first component sketch and adjust it a little bit in order to save some time when making the other side of the box. Make sure you activate the new component before pasting the sketch. All we basically have to do is adjust the corner joint. I will delete the mirror outline so it doesn't mess with us. Don't forget to change this dimension to length. Let me quickly remodel the corner. It's important here to use the same distance that we did for the other side of the box, so the joints fit nicely. When everything is adjusted, we can mirror the contour line and extrude the outlines to finish the second side. Last but not least, we have to design the box floor. Again, I recommend starting with construction lines. It's important to set these distances as length and the width as well, so there are no surprises when assembling the components. Let's add a line to the side to illustrate the place for the tenon. The same on the top here. Obviously, this distance should be the same as the material thickness, so let's write plywood in the window. Now let's add a center line and sketch a construction line here. It will serve as a symmetry axis when we are mirroring the outline. Okay. The frame is done and we can start sketching the outline. Make sure the tenon is the same width as the mortise. When that is done, we can simply mirror the outline using the center line and the sketch line. After extruding the box floor, it's finished as well. Let me quickly assemble the box so we can make sure everything fits. It seems it does. Let's adjust some of the user parameters to see if it works as intended. And it's a success! This is how you can make a parametric design. Obviously, this was a simple example, but once you get the basics and feel comfortable with user parameters, there are no limits on what you can design. By the way, if you want to make a box like this for yourself, and you would like to skip all the designing, I uploaded the DXF files on Aribabox page. The link is in the description. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe for more designing and CNC related content. Stay creative and I'll see you next time!